What's up, everybody? Coach Mills here, coming at you with a brand new Halo Infinite video. And have you ever been shot or taken damage randomly and you have no idea where it's coming from? Or you're consistently losing gunfights again and again? Well, you need to learn the ultimate peeking guide. So we're gonna break down all the different types of peeks and simple strategies that you need to incorporate in order to dominate every single gunfight. But studies show that those who smash the like, subscribe, dominate in the bedroom instead. So don't be a smash the like and subscribe. But without further ado, let's jump into the video. Now, the first thing that I want to go over is one of the most fundamental principles to peeking, and especially in Halo, a lot of people don't understand this, and that's why they're taking damage from people that they just simply don't see. Now, to best explain this tip, let's break down a scenario. If an enemy is tucked into a corner or holding close behind a door, the corner of that edge or box is known as what I call the pivot angle. And this is incredibly important to keep track of. Now, distancing matters from this pivot angle here, because the distance that your enemy is from the angle and the distance that you are from this angle directly matter to who gets to see the enemy first. The person who is the furthest away from said pivot angle is going to be able to see the enemy far before, potentially, you see them. And now, directly what this means is if you were very far away from the pivot angle and you're slowly peeking an enemy that's tucked into a corner, they might not even see you, and you can see entire parts of their body before they have any idea that you're trying to peek them at all. This also means that you could potentially speed peek an enemy tucked into a cubby, and they're gonna have far less time to react, because while you saw half of their body before they saw any of you, by the time you're all the way fully peeking them, they basically get like a millisecond less time to react to that, which means you're probably gonna kill them. Now, keep in mind, this is an incredibly important FPS tactic, and I guess it's a geometry lesson as well, but it's super important to understand in any FPS nonetheless. Now, that being said, specifically for Halo, there's a lot of peek tactics that you need to incorporate. So let's talk about each one, the pros and cons of using them, when you should use them, and when you should probably not. Now, the first thing that you need to understand about Halo is that there's no movement inaccuracy, meaning you can jump, you can run, and you're still going to be perfectly accurate, which means that a lot of these peeking strategies are going to be fundamentally different than other games that have some sort of movement disadvantage or movement downside to your aim. Now, the first tip I'm going to give you has to do with sprinting. It's pretty obvious to say this, but if you're sprinting, your gun is not out, and peeking an enemy while you're sprinting is going to be a really easy way for them to shoot you before you get to shoot them back. This is why if you're going into any unknown areas, unknown space, and you want to take a fair gunfight with any enemies nearby, you should not be sprinting. You should be walking and clearing the area. The reason that you do this is you need your gun out. If you are running in, even if it's only for a millisecond, the enemy gets that first burst off on you, you're 100% gonna lose that duel. And it's incredibly important, especially as enemies get very proficient with their aim. You need to make sure that you are shooting an enemy first, and that means walking and clearing an angle or an area with your gun out rather than just running around the map like a psychopath. Now, the next thing that we need to talk about is the jump peek, and this really relates directly to what we talked about, where there's no jumping inaccuracy, there's no moving inaccuracy. So if an enemy is far, really far away from you, and there's certain amounts of obstruction, if you scope in with the BR or a sniper or whatever, and you jump up, you're going to be able to see enemies barely at the apex of your jump, you're gonna output a little bit of damage, and then you're gonna go fall right back down. This could be a great way to add in some damage to the enemy, barely peek them, like they have to be literally holding exactly where you're gonna jump in order to deal damage to you, and you get added information as well. Now, it's important to only incorporate this jump peek if you're pretty far away from the enemy. You definitely don't want to be just jumping in front of an enemy. It means that your movement is really, really static and it's very trackable, so an enemy is gonna be able to easily follow you through the air, beam you down, no matter what weapon they're doing. So while a jump peek can be useful in a lot of ways, if an enemy is weak and you're trying to push them, or if you're trying to jump peek from far away, it's not something that you should do too much. Don't just jump in every single engagement, and don't just randomly jump around corners and full commit to a team fight. You're gonna just get completely destroyed. Now, the next type of peek that we gotta talk about is the jiggle peek. And what a jiggle peek is you are behind cover and you're gonna move outside of cover, or just where you can see the enemy with your weapon. You're gonna fire at them typically, and then you're going to what we call jiggle, or go back into cover. You're peeking out, you're firing, you're peeking back in. You're peeking out, you're firing, you're peeking back in. And this is super useful in a lot of different ways. First off, you're not peeking for very long, right? In between your shots, you're going back behind cover. So you're only peeking or exposing yourself when you're actually shooting the enemy. Now, this can be very good in 1v1s, especially if there's pillars or obstructions where while you're reloading or in between your shots, you shoot at them, you duck behind a natural cover and you're being protected in that time frame. Then you peek back out, you shoot them. And this is one of the most important strategies that you need to master when trying to win gunfights, because you're being very deliberate with the LOS or the line of sight between you and the enemy, and you're not peeking them unless you're doing damage, and you could potentially completely throw an enemy off their rhythm when trying to 1v1 you. Now, it's important to understand that when you de-jiggle an angle, there is a tiny gap in information, and this can be very important because an enemy could hypothetically, you know, move or throw a grenade and you jiggle and then you jiggle back out and a grenade explodes right on top of you. That's why it's important to think about where an enemy could have moved. Since you de-peaked even in a millisecond, where could they have gone and where are they likely to be? And it's also important to listen for potential grenades coming your way. Now, jiggle peek can also be really useful for de-scoping enemies and challenging enemies from really far away, just putting pressure on them. If you know they're trying to hold a certain angle or a certain door frame on the high ground, you can jiggle peek and fire, or even jiggle peek pre-fire, and all you're doing is you're just spraying bullets in that general direction and forcing them to no longer play that door frame or that window or that high ground by outputting damage while at the same time taking very little damage. You could also de-scope potentially a sniper user, and the faster you jiggle, the tighter you jiggle and potentially pre-fire, the less opportunity that an enemy has to snipe you when you're doing so. Now, that being said, they still could potentially snipe you. There's a really small window if they have fast enough reaction time, and that's where the shoulder peek comes in. The shoulder peek is a very underrated peek, and it's pretty powerful if you do it correctly. And all it is instead of actually peeking out and firing at an enemy, you're peeking out with just your shoulder, not even really looking at the enemy, trying to elicit a response. Whether that's grenades or whether that's a sniper shot, you're basically just trying to fake an engage. Fake a swing out, and enemies often will either shoot and miss, and then you'll use that as an opportunity to swing out and push in or challenge, or they'll spam some grenades because all you did was peek your shoulder out a couple of times thinking that you're gonna actually swing out, and then they wasted all their grenades and now you don't have to worry about them in the preceding fight. Now, a combination of shoulder peeking and jiggle peeking can better help what I call the Ferrari peek, which is just a really wide and fast peek where you're going way out of natural cover and trying to peek really, really far and challenge an enemy in open space. If you jiggle peek many times or shoulder peek many times, an enemy might think, hey, he's gonna keep doing it. I'm gonna throw a close grenade. I'm gonna hold my crosshair really close to the wall. And then out of nowhere, you go really wide, and you can even add onto this even more so with something like a thruster, where an enemy thinks that you're just gonna keep peeking that really, really close angle right next to the natural cover. And then all of a sudden you're way out really far. They have to flick all the way to you or slowly track depending on what device you're using, and they might just get completely slaughtered because you're already pre-adjusting to where they are. And now, I hope you learned something, and if you did, please smash that like and subscribe so you can support the channel. And how has your climb to Onyx been? Have you reached your goals, and what is your biggest tip that you can give to your fellow Game Leap subscribers down below? Thank you so much for coming by. Hope you enjoyed the video. See you next time.